Hello students, welcome to the session. So in this video we'll discuss about the history of chromotherapy in Western countries. Color has been used as long as 13,000 years ago. In the beginning, from the cave paintings, they used color in Western countries. So in the beginning they used only primary colors, that are red, yellow and blue, for the treatment purpose. Ancient Egyptians, they have more conscious about their bodies, so they used color for the ailments and cures. So in centuries ago, in the wall of Nile River, the ancient Egyptians, they worshipped the god, that is sun. They believed that sun is considered as god and he is the giver of health and prolonger of the life. So it is the sunlight spectrum that is composed of different colors, and they are considered as the prime source of longevity, health and healing. Egyptians, they mainly had the concept of believing in God, and they used to worship the God, and they used to take bath in sunlight, that is they used to expose their body to the sunlight, and they believed that sunlight spectrum, which is composed of 7 different colors, which provides longevity, health and healing to the body. Ancient peoples of Tibet, China, Greece and Egypt, they also had the more conscious about their bodies, and they also had the inner knowledge of the beneficial effects of the various colors. That's why they went into deep study of different colors, and they built temples for healing, and they use gems through which sunlight is used. So when they were building the temple, they used to use different color gemstones in the walls of the temples, because by the use of different gems or different colored gemstones, they can heal the body by themselves. And they created colors of red, yellow and orange from pigments in the soil. So different colored pigments, they used to naturally get it from the different colored soil. Ancient Egyptians and Greeks, they used colored crystals, mineral stones and dyes for the healing purpose, and they painted sanctuaries in various shapes of colors for the use of treatment. So they built the temple in such a way that the floor of the temple, they were offered green as grass, and blue was also used to mimic the color of the sky. So in temples, they used to color the floor in green color, and they also used blue color to mimic the color of the sky, and they worshipped the sun, which in modern time is valued for its existence of mankind, not only for the heat but its healing purpose. And other methods of healing includes grinding of heating crystals and gemstones that would be ingested. They also used to burn the gemstones, and they used to consume the ashes of the burnt gemstones, and also they used to take it orally, and they also used it as an ornament. And they built great halls of color healing. So here they used to take bath in light, which is filtered through different colored glass panels or windows. So they used to take bath in different colored light, and their use of colors for treatment were used in 2 different ways, that is direct and indirect. So indirect, which involves the use of stones, dyes, oils, ointments and plasters to treat the diseases. That is, they are not taking it orally or they are not taking it directly, but they are using different colored stones, different colored dyes, oils and different colored ointments for the treating illness. And direct method, which involves exposing oneself directly to the sunlight, that is called as direct treatment. And during 980 AD, Avicenna used color to diagnose and treatment. Avicenna, he created a chart to associate various colors in each physical condition. And he said that color is an observable symptom of disease. So Avicenna, he told that color can, by knowing at the color, by observing the different colors, one can diagnose the disease. So that is, in modern term, we call it as chromodiagnosis. So chromodiagnosis means the diagnosing the disease by different colors. That is, the by observing the color of the nail, urine, stool, eyes, conjunctiva, and different parts of the body. So by knowing it the different colors and abnormalities of the colors, the physician can diagnose the different diseases of the body. And he observed that the color blue has soothing qualities which would reduce the flow of blood. So blue is also considered as the cooling color, so it is soothing in nature, so which will help to reduce the blood flow in the body. And he also used blue as a remedy for injury, burns, aches, and also for relaxing the muscles, because it has got the soothing effect. Aristotle, Plato, and Pythagoras, they also studied the properties of different colors. And he concluded that by mixing two colors, a third color is produced. That in modern term, we call it as secondary colors. In 6th century BC, Orpheus used vibrational medicine of color and light as mode of healing. And Apuleius revealed the diagnosis of epilepsy with the flickering light. That's how they used color for the diagnosis and for the healing purpose in the body. And Ptolemy, he proposed the concept that when light entered into eyes, it stimulates the brain centers and produces the feeling of euphoria. So the word meaning of euphoria is a sense of extreme happiness and self-confidence. So he tells that when we are exposed to particular color, then the brain centers are stimulated and person will feel happy and excited. So Paracelsus, he introduced color philosophy, and he used color with music and herb as a complementary medicine. And Isaac Newton, he also formed a wheel of colors which is harmonious together and others which might clash. So these are the some of the contribution of Westerns to the field of chromotherapy. So here they proved it scientifically, so they believed in the concept of color therapy. So there are so many evidences which will support the history of chromotherapy. Thank you.